Hi, today we're going to be talking about conversion path reports in Google Analytics 4. These are a really helpful way to see your user's journey for completing a conversion event on your site. Starting out, I'm on the main property homepage, and I'm going to go over here to advertising. From there, I'm going to click conversion paths. And now I'm looking at my conversion path report. So of course, yours is going to look a little different from mine based on your conversion events and the data. But this is just the overall report we've got to start. So I'm going to show you how we can adjust some of these filters to get the view we want. Starting out, you always want to make sure you have the right date range. I'm going to stick with March, apply that. And now we know we're looking at the right range of data. Next up, I'm going to adjust my conversion events I'm looking at. Right now I'm looking at all 18 of mine, but say you just want to look at one or two, you can adjust that. I just want to look at in-app purchases right now. So I'm going to apply that. And now I'm just looking at those conversion events. So I'll go back to all 18, apply. Now we're looking at everything again. Next up, you can adjust the path length. That's referring to these touch points here. So one thing to note, you'll notice that most of the events are going into this late touch points column. That's because the late touch points is referring to the last touch point before conversion. So if you only have one touch point, you might think it would go in this early touch point here, but it's actually going to the late touch points because it's still the last touch point before conversion. Again, with only two touch points, instead of going from early to mid, it's going to go early to late touch point because the second one is your last touch point. So if I want to adjust that, let's say I want to look at everything greater than two or three touch points because I want to see what's going in that mid touch point and early touch point range. I'm going to do over three touch points, apply that. Okay, now we're seeing that those are going through the display channel. And then if you want to go back to that first view, you're going to go back to all touch points and apply that. Okay, next up, you can adjust the users. There are two ways you can get to this screen. The first is just from the path link to all users, and then it's going to bring you to this page. You can also get there by clicking Add Filter, and it's going to bring you to the exact same page we were just on. So you can adjust the users you're looking at, see different views. Say you are attracting a younger audience and you just want to see how they are completing conversions on your site. I'm going to scroll down to demographics and age. Then I'll pick my dimension. I'll do 18 to 24 and OK. And your dimension values are going to change based on what you chose right here. You can add up to five conditions if you want to get more specific with the data. So I'm going to apply just this one for now. And now I'm looking at users just in that 18 to 24 age range. So to get rid of that, you just click right here and remove the filter. Okay, next up, we're going to talk about how you can adjust the view of your tables here. You can change the channel group you're looking at. Right now we're looking at the default channel group, but say you want to look at source, medium, or campaign, you can click on any one of those. I'm going to click source. And this is telling us the pages that these are coming from, Google, invite a friend. This is also going to adjust what you're seeing down here. You can also adjust that same thing right here. But I'll show you again how it changes the data down here. Okay, and we'll go back to that default channel group for now. Next up, you can change your attribution models. So we're starting out with a data-driven model. So this assigns credit to each touch point based on how the touch point changes the conversion probability. It's what it's always going to default to on your page. Next up, we have our last click model. This assigns all the conversion credit just to that last touch point. Our first click is just the opposite, assigning all the conversion credit to the first touch point. And then linear spreads it out evenly among the early, mid, and late touch point. Okay. Our position-based model is a little different than linear. You get 40% of conversion credit to the first touch point and the last touch point, or sorry, the early touch point and the late touch point, not necessarily the first and last. Because if you have a first one, it's just going to go straight to this late touch point if it's the only one. And then your mid touch point is only going to get 20% as you see right there. time decay is only going to show you events from the last 7 days. And then last click for ads preferred is just like last click up here, but it's just taking it from your ad conversion credit or users that are coming from ads. So I'll go back to the data-driven default one right here. Okay, and then at last but not least, you're gonna see everything broken down even more right here. You can see conversions, purchase revenue, days to conversion, and touch points to conversion. You can adjust how many pages you're seeing at a time. This might take a second. Oh, there it goes. You can also scroll through, say you just wanna find the fifth top one, you can do it that way. You can adjust the views of these. All very easy and user-friendly. But if you have any questions about anything else related to conversion paths, anything else we can touch on a little bit more in depth, let us know in the comments. Thank you for checking out our video and have a great day.